Hello everyone and welcome to Night Graphics. We are discussing the chapter of transforming objects, and till now we have discussed the four types of transformations, which are moving, rotating, reflecting and scaling the objects. And in this video, we are going to discuss the last type of transform function, which is shearing. Shearing means slanting or skewing the object, and for shearing, we have a tool for it lying here grouped with the scale tool. Let's check out its available options. First of all, select the object you want to shear and then select the shear tool. Then, like other transform tools, here also you set the access point and then you can drag to freely shear the selected object. Now, shear can be done along the horizontal axis line like this, and it can be done along with the vertical axis line like this. The access point set by you will be referred as a horizontal and vertical guideline along which shearing will happen. Like here we have this axis point, and now the shear will happen referring this point as the axis or the center point like this. Similarly, if I click this point as reference point, then it will act as axis or the center point and shear will happen like this. You can also set the shear through its dialog box, which you can open by double clicking this share button. Double clicking will open the dialog box by automatically making the axis point at center of the shape. However, you can open the dialog box in respect to any reference point by pressing Alt key and then clicking at any desired reference point. Now here we have this corner point as axis. Let's try shearing through this dialog box. Here we can enter the shear angle value. Here the horizontal axis is selected, which means the degrees will affect horizontally like this. And if I change the axis line to be vertical, then the degrees change will affect along the vertical line. You can also set the angle of axis line from here before shear the object from here. Like here, the angle of horizontal axis is 0 degree and the vertical axis is 90 degrees. Likewise, you can set your own axis line. Let me do a practical to make you clear how it will work. Both these shapes are identical. With Alt key pressed, I click here to set it as reference point and open its dialog box. Right now the horizontal axis is selected, that is straight 0 degree line is gonna be the axis line, and here I shear it for 60 degrees and the result is this. Now I will select this shape, and with same reference point the dialog box is open. Here I will change the axis to be 45 degrees first and then shear it for same 60 degrees. And here you can see the result is entirely different from this, because here the shear was done along with this horizontal line and here the shear was done along with the 45 degrees axis line. Then here we have the option of copy button, which will make a copy as per the set values while preserving the original one. Like here I set the shear value to be minus 60 degrees and press copy, and it will make a new copy accordingly. So this is all about the shear option. In the last four videos and in this video, we have discussed all the five transform functions. And in the next video, we will discuss about few transforming options and we will do a practical covering all the functions of transformation. Thanks for watching Night Graphics, and subscribe to this channel for more upcoming tutorials.